Today we're going to look at the statistics menu icon in the fx-9750G3 graphing calculator from Casio. If you have another graphing calculator from Casio, it's the same functionality for the most part. But I wanted to show you basically how everything in the menu that you need is right there in the menu on the screen using either the function buttons or the option buttons. So a couple little reminders here. To get to a menu icon that you're interested in, you can use the scroll bar. This takes you up, down, left, right. And once you're on the menu that you're interested in, you can hit execute right away, or you could also hit the number or the letter that happens to be with that particular menu icon. So right now, let's just hit the two, and that brings us right into the statistics. So you'll notice statistics starts with a list. You could bring in a list from somewhere else if you wanted to do that. You can also, if you notice, there's this subheading, so you can actually arrow up to that and use the alphabet keys to type in actual headings if you choose. So I could do that. Let's just say, we'll just say A, subheading A for right now. And then to enter, so you can enter many lists, as many as you want, bring them in from somewhere else, and you're going to enter them. But what I want to point out here now is while we're in the statistics menu, the first thing I would suggest whenever you go into a menu icon is to look to see if there's some settings that you can change. And so to do that, you'll see setup is right here. You want to hit shift menu, and this brings you to the setup for that menu icon if it's applicable. Some menu icons don't have settings, so you'll notice that as well. But right now we do. So right now it's talking about the statistics window is set to auto. We can do it manually if we want, but it's nice to have it to auto because it will automatically fit it to whatever your data might be. So if it's large numbers, it's nice to have auto on. This lets you do the residuals from the list if you want. Right now we have right now it's none. We can use it as list. We're going to leave it where it is. You can pull a list from a file if you want. This right here, that subheading, it's on automatically by default. You can turn it off if you don't want the students to have a subheading, if you don't think it's necessary. You can change the way fractions might appear. Right now they're set to be mixed numbers. Maybe we want them to be just in standard form. So the setup allows you to kind of control some of the things that you see. You can put a background in. So sometimes a picture can be in the background of your statistics. So you could put that in from the picture list. So lots of different things. So this is a good place to go when you go into a menu just to see the setup. Another button that's really important in every menu is the exit button. Exit will get you back to the screen before. And so this is going to take us back. And this happens to be the initial screen. So that's good. So one thing I want to point out is that these functions line up with the choices, the options that you have within that menu. So that's how this works. So if we want a graph, if I hit F1 right now, you can see that I have three possible graphs for the statistics. And once I hit a function or an option, it gives me more options, right? So I hit graph, and now here's my options within graph. And I can select which graph I want to turn on or off. And let's hit exit. Brings me back. I can set up my graph. So you'll notice in setup that when you have your statistical graphs, and there's three options here, that you have lots of statistical plots available to you. So I'm in the statistical setup. So my graph types are scatter, XY, pi. This always means there are more choices. So notice I can do histograms and bar graphs, lots of different things. There's still more. There we go. Different types of plots that I can do. So lots and lots of choices. And now we're back to where we started, which was scatter plots. So graph type in statistics, there's lots of different options of what you can do. And depending on the option that you choose, so let's say I chose to do a bar plot. Notice that my options change. Where's the data coming from? List one. And so based on the choice that I made, it's going to choose, give me different choices up here that I can then select and control. So let's hit exit again. So I got to that by going to setup. And so once you're in setup, you have lots of different options. You can change the type of graph. You can change where the data is coming from, how long it is, those types of things. Let's go back to So you'll notice if I hit a box plot this time, list one, I can change my frequency. I can have my outliers on or off. So depending on what you choose in statistics, you get different options for each type of graph. And you can have up to three graphs on in statistics. So we're going to hit exit. So that's under setup. Now I'm going to go back because we were in graph. So remember, I hit graph first and graph gave me these options and we explored some of the options within there. Let's go back. So calculate, what's that in statistics? So obviously you've entered some data in however many lists. If you do calculate, notice that you can do one or two variable calculations. You can do regressions. And you can have the option to set it up again. So notice that I can choose where I want the variables coming from, which list is doing X, which one's doing Y. So if I have more than two lists, that comes in handy. And I can do different types of regressions. So here's the different regressions. And again, here's that arrow that allows you to see more options. So you'll see there's lots of different types of regressions that you can do. Let's hit exit. So I hit exit to came back. So we've looked at graph. We looked at calculate. What's test? So again, we're in statistics. So obviously these are statistical tests. So you'll notice that I have different types of tests that I can do. If I choose one of them, it's going to then give me options. So each time you make a choice, it gives you options within that choice. And that's the nice thing about Casio is all your choices are right here. You don't have to go hunting for different, you know, buttons down here to figure out where things are. Everything you need's right here on the screen. And when you select an option, it gives you more options within it, right? So there's lots of different ways to do that. And to get back, you just hit exit. So let's go back again. So we've looked at graph, calculate, test. Let's look at this. So these are inverses, I think. And then distributions you can do. So lots of different types of distributions. And remember, again, whenever you see this, you have more choices. So lots of different options there. So let's get back. We did distribution. So let's look at our more. So you'll notice there's different ways to sort the list top to bottom. Hit exit to get back. You can edit the list, delete the list, insert values where you didn't need them, those types of things. So exit gets us back. So we've looked at, I don't know why exit is not getting me back. There we go. All right, so we're back here at the main screen. Now we have looked at all of the different options within the options that are come automatically with statistics. But one thing you always want to also look at when you are in any menu icon in the graphing calculators, once you're in it, you'll have all the options that are there that are the standard ones that come. But then check this option button because that gives you even more options. So notice this lets us do lists. This lets us do complex calculations with our statistical values. It lets us do other calculations, right? So we can use these lists to do calculations as well. So options gives us lots of different things that we can do. So you'll notice there's lots of different things that you can do. So don't forget to also look at option button because you have even more that you can do within a menu icon. So you have your standard ones that come with that menu, and then there's the options that here. This is just an overview, so explore each one, see what each one does, and use the menu icons and menu options that are relevant to what you need to do.